I've always been a big fan of sauerkraut, the traditional German cabbage dish.
Mine has a colourful pink twist.
And with my sauerkraut, I'm going to do the French croquette potato nuggets. And what I love about this recipe, it uses up ingredients you have in your fridge already.
I'm using 250 grams of mashed potato and 100 grams of leftover veg. I have carrots and peas.
Nice bit of salt. Plenty of black pepper. Don't be shy.
I'm making round croquette. You could do traditional cylinders. The key is keeping them the same size.
I'm a big fan of not wasting any food. I grew up with a mum who always used up leftovers. We used to have leftover night. Malaysian rendang curry, spaghetti bolognese, Sunday roast, Austrian schnitzel, loads of different dishes on leftover night. It was a bit like a meeting of the UN. So never one to waste any food. It's the worst thing you could do.
Lay out 4 plates for the coating. One with plain flour, the next with 2 whisked eggs, and then another with breadcrumbs.
I find the easiest way of doing this is to do all the flour process in one go, then do all the egg process in one go. Otherwise, if you do it flour, egg, breadcrumbs, you always end up with lots of flour in the egg and then lots of egg in the breadcrumbs, and it ends up a bit messy. Make sure you don't have too much egg sticking on there. Put it off and then pop it into your breadcrumbs. And repeat.
There's enough for around 10 croquettes.
All right, you can save this for some scrambled eggs or an omelette. And now the final coating, the breadcrumbs. Key with this bit is making sure you get those breadcrumbs to stick really well. You want to have that crispy crust all the way around that croquette. They're all ready to go. Just need a baking dish, a little bit of oil. So the croquette are gonna go in a preheated oven at 200 degrees. And what you're looking for is that golden crust all the way around the croquette. So you might need to turn them over.
To go with this crispy croquette, I'm making a vibrant pink sauerkraut. It all starts with finely slicing around 1 kilo of the humble star cabbage.
So I'm using a mandolin, but you could use a food processor or you could use a knife. The thickness is about a couple millimetres. So that's the cabbage shredded. I'm gonna pop that in my bowl. When you're doing this process, what you're doing is basically capitalising on the natural bacteria in the air, and that's combined with the salt, and that creates like lactofermentation.
Essentially, starches and sugar in the veg break down into lactoacid. Next, the colour, beetroot.
This is very powerful. It's going to give the sauerkraut a fantastic pink colour and also give my fingers a bright pink colour. I'm going to add some juniper berries, and they give it a lovely flavour. If you don't have juniper berries, you could use some black peppercorns.
Finally, salt. Key for creating perfect fermentation conditions and helping to kill off bad bacteria.
Now, this is where a big bowl comes in handy, because you just really need to kind of get into the cabbage and give it a good, like, massage. I'm always thinking about colours, and I thought sauerkraut, when you look at it in a jar, it looks a bit beige. Doesn't look very appetizing. And I was like, why not make it bright pink? Definitely can feel how the cabbage is starting to soften a little bit in my hand. It's not as hard or crunchy as beforehand. We're getting lots of nice cabbage juice at the bottom and the cabbage is like broken down. So you want to use a glass jar and you want to make sure you sterilize your glass jar. And there are two ways you can sterilize a glass jar. You can either put it through the hot wash in the dishwasher, or you can pop it in an oven at 160 degrees for 10 minutes and then it'll be sterilized. All right, I'm gonna add my kraut to my jar. So pack all your cabbage in there. And then don't forget that little bit of liquid that needs to go in there too. Oh. To make the cabbage stay down, you need a couple weights. So I have these, I'm gonna add.
The weights push the veg down into the liquid, helping with the fermentation process. A filled heavy smaller jar will also work.
It takes about a minimum of 4 days, leaving it in a room at 20 degrees, and then the bacteria will start working and the cabbage will develop flavour. So from the fourth day, what you can do is start tasting it, and when it reaches that level of sourness you like, you can put it in the fridge.
The croquettes have been crisping for around 15 minutes.
Let's have a little peek. Yes. Look at that. They've got a lovely golden colour. Now, here's the kraut I made earlier. Let's have a little look inside this croquette. So you have that soft centre, that crispy golden crust with the soft centre. Have a little taste. Super hot. But can you hear that crunch? Oh, I love a bit of crunch. And top it all off with some sauerkraut. Mmm. That is really good kraut. I love the fact that, you know, it still has that freshness, but it has that light bit of, you know, tartness and acidity coming through. Simple, but satisfying.